Welcome children in the science class. Today we will start new chapter, that is chapter 6, insect. So the question is, what are insects? Insects are tiny creatures. You must have often seen such small creatures such as house flies, mosquitoes, butterflies, etc. around us. These small tiny creatures are known as insects. Insects are the largest group in animals on the earth. So, insects are the largest group of animals on the earth. Children, here you can see the pictures of few insects that you can see common everywhere. So, you have to identify and name them. First one, second one, third one and fourth one. These are the few insects which you can see in your everyday life also. You have to identify and write their names. So, the next is, you can see here the pictures of different types of insects. Okay. Now, there are more than a million kind of insects that are found on the earth. So, there are 1 million kinds of insects that are found on this earth. These includes flies, mosquitoes, grasshopper, butterflies, beetles and bees, etc. They differ in size, shape, color and many other features as you have seen in the pictures. Here you can see there are flies and mosquitoes. So, insects do not have bones. These insects don't have bones. All insects have three pairs of legs, that is six legs in all. Many of them have two pairs of membranous wings that help them to fly. Membranous wings means the outer covering that covers the back part or the outer portion of the insects. It contains wings that helps them to fly, as in case of house fly, it is very common. Okay. Some insects also sit on the flowers in the garden. So, there is another activity for you. Let us perform a simple activity to observe this. So, what you have to do it? You have to keep some fresh flowers in one pot and some brightly colored paper flowers in another pot. Place both the pots in the balcony or veranda of your house. Observe them from a distance. Do you see any insect attracted to the flowers? Which type of flowers do they visit? So, this is an activity and you have to do it. Okay. Now, there is, you can see the pictures of a butterfly, house honeybee and bumblebee. Okay. Now, insects like butterflies, honeybees and bumblebees get attracted towards fresh flowers. These insects, they get attracted towards the fresh flowers, and this bumblebee, these insects make sounds while flying. These insects while visiting a flower also help in pollination. When insects sit on flowers, pollen grains stick in their legs or wings and get transferred to one place to another place. Okay. This pollination is the process of sifting of pollen grains from one place to another, is called pollination. And these pollen grains are the powdery substances that are found in the flowers. Okay. It is given in Do You Know? Insects like bee, ants and termites live in well organized colonies, that is, they live in groups. They are called social insects. Now, there are two types of insects. One is useful insects and the other is harmful insects. So, today we will learn about useful insects. There are some insects which are very useful for us. Let us know about them. First one is honeybee. Honeybees are one of the insects which are very useful for us. They build their hives on trees and roofs of old buildings. Honeybees are usually attracted to sweet-smelling flowers. Such flowers produce a sweet liquid called nectar. Honeybees suck nectar from flowers and carry it to the hive where they live. A beehive consists of many six-sided chamber called combs. So this beehive, it consists of six-sided chambers that is called combs. Honeybees stores the nectar in these combs and the nectar is collected in these combs. The nectar changes into honey. Honey is collected from a beehive by lighting a fire under it. We get honey by this way. The heat and smoke drives the bees out of the hive. The honey collectors then remove the hive and collect the honey and store it. As you can see here, it is given in, do you know, a colony of bees in a hive has about 50,000 to 80,000 workers bee. So in a colony of a bee, there are about 50,000 to 80,000 worker bees which collect nectar. It also has a few hundred male bees, and in a colony of bees, there are also few hundred of male bees called drones. The male bees are called drones. There is, however, only one queen bee in a hive. Now, second useful insect is silk moth. We get silk from silk moth, which grows on mulberry leaves. The silk moth secretes a liquid which changes into a fine thread. The moth weaves a cover around itself with this thread. This cover is called a cocoon. These cocoons are collected and silk thread is obtained from them. Here you can see the silk moth. Now, next useful insect is lac insect. Lac insects usually grow on banyan trees. They secrete a semi-solid substances called lac. Lac is used in paints, varnishes. Varnishes means grease or lubricant, printing ink, and for making bangles and similar things. Now, next useful insect is ladybird beetle. Okay, here you can see the pictures of a ladybird beetle also. It eats a large number of pests that are harmful for plants. So this ladybird beetle, it eats the harmful insects that harms the plants. And it is given in, do you know, rearing or breeding of honeybee for collecting of honey is called apiculture. The collecting of honey is called apiculture, and while rearing of silk worms for getting silk is called sericulture. Okay, so to children, this much is today. Next day we will proceed ahead. Thank you and have a good day.